Morning, y'all. Almost afternoon, but I'm here and I'm back at it. Like I said in my last video, for those that watched it, when I do these videos for y'all to learn, y'all got to watch the whole videos to become a good trader. I mean, you have to watch the whole videos. You gotta, you know, make time for yourself for you to learn these things, how these platforms work, how stocks work. How dollar cost averaging works and everything else. Give y'all the game free. All I ask is subscribe to my channel, hit the like button, and watch my recent videos. Okay. Today my account is at $33,011. I am up $485, which is 1.49% today. For the last 2 days we had the market was sort of bullish. It was green. So I didn't do a lot of trading. Thing on yesterday, I might have traded $20, brought like 6 stocks. But it wasn't enough for me to do no video. Like I told you, I'm going to do video Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays only. Tuesday and Thursdays, chill on trading so I can, you know, keep some of my cash to trade. You know, try to stretch my money out. Anyway, but let's get to it. I can see today that the market is green, so I don't think it's gonna be a lot of red, which means I probably won't do a lot of trading or buying stocks. So let's see what it do. I do need some Rocket. What Rocket got down to? Dang, Rocket went down to 720 today. I catch that on another one to rebound. KeyCorp Bank, that done went back up. I like that round of $9 something mark. Walgreens, but I can do this one. I seen an article about Walgreens, Rite Aids, and CVS. So something about, I think workers going on strike. A lot of workers was like walking off of the jobs or something. I said, man, they gonna end up catching hell, man. Reason I say that is because they already got the thefts and stuff going on with, you know, Walgreens, Rite Aid, CVS's, and the Dollar General. They got a lot of theft and stuff going on with them. AGNC, they end up having good third quarter earnings, so that's one of the reasons why this stock is going up. Excuse me, which I'm gonna let all my shares ride up and do a swing trade. Probably back to $9 and better mark. International paper, let that come down. MO was down for the last couple of days. Oh yeah, let me get some of that. Get $5 worth. MO. That's a buy. I buy them on the Altria at $32 and under. Where you at, 3M? Yesterday she's at $91. Alright, get some of that. Like Altria and 3M, them buying whole stocks. I mean, they do increase their dividend like every year. So them stocks you just buying whole forever, to be honest. You don't never sell all of it. You just scalp profits, if anything. $31.46, I can do that. Think about throwing another $500 into my Robinhood account. I usually do $500 a month. And see, Unity Group got a 52-week low at 294 with 448. I'm going to let the dividend just ride and collect the dividend until it get around that price. Wendy's 894, 1819, nope. Let Wendy's come down some. They very, very rare. come down a lot. But rising, I got 43 shares. I'm finally in profits. I sold my other portfolio shares of it in my Cash App account. I sold like 89 shares at like $33 just to get out of it. I was kind of deep in it because I know I had another whatever many shares, 43 shares over here. I said I could just dollar cost averaging this one if it goes back down versus buying in two different portfolios during these times here. Never knew all this war in Israel and war in Russia and all this other stuff was going and interest rate hikes was going to affect the market the way that it has. So I got out, sold my other portfolio to free up cash so I can DCA down in other stocks. I can catch the mean energy some other time. Ain't no big deal. And Dow was coming down in this one. 47.88. 45. Get $3 worth. This and not an expensive stock, but it kind of is. That's like $50 a share. So I can buy a little bit of it. 512, 464. Catch that when it's down some. I think TRTX had bad earnings. I did see that yesterday. But that should come on down. Crestwood, I'm good. CQP. Yes, Crestwood, sorry. SBSW, I know I need to come down to that. 492. Like I say, you don't. This might be just last two days have been bullish, looking bullish. You don't know if this is a dead cat bounce or not. See, the only thing I don't like about Robinhood, you can't have a buy order. A sell order and a buy order at the same old time. That's one thing I don't like about it. It's a buy and hold stock too. Beatrice. So I'm getting $5 worth. And I'm gonna put a buy order in at they got a 52 week low at 874. I thought it was 871. Anyway, I'll do it in a minute. I thought it was 871 I seen. Anyway, I'm going to put one at 871 anyway. About three shares. If it hit 871. Until then, I'm a dollar cost average. Spend $3 to $5 a day in it. Lowering my average cost. Goro should have came on down. It's gonna do the same old thing to me. See, I got to cancel all my orders. See, Robinhood, man, you just can't not free like that just to trade at will on here. See, but I got partially filled order. At 48 cents, so I'm not gonna bother. I want it to fill all the way. I'm gonna take that money and reinvest it. Lower my average cost. Ben Franklin Resources 21.58. I'll let that come down. What they is, I can't. They gonna come down some more anyway. I catch that on the rebound. No matter fast, I need to come down to this 68.50. Yeah. Think the Fed's talking tomorrow. We're gonna see what happened with that. 1059, 1027. They got a P ratio of 31.9. This here gonna come down some more. About $2 worth of DEA. That ain't no big deal of a stop to me. Elias Bernstein, 2862. Nothing wrong with that. Where I'm at? I let it come down. See what's gonna happen. Shoe Carnival. I should be good with them. I had a solid foundation with them. Nike. Damn, I'm gonna catch Nike around that $92 mark. This thing will not go on down, man. Do what I gotta do. All right, CHCT, some healthcare. This one been, yeah. This one had bad earnings or something. Ooh, PE ratio at 88.2. This why I'm kind of funny with you know, people got their own defining of penny stock. Some say under $1 billion market cap. Some say a stock that's under $5 and under. I try not to buy companies that have a market cap below $1 billion. So just in case things get bad, you know, they won't have no free cash flow sitting. Oh, you know, when they get into a jam, they ain't got any money to get out of a jam. Should I say? 374, 342, I can wait. I just want to let Brandywine take care of stuff with the dividends, to be honest. Okay, Black & Decker. I'm really aiming towards, like, buying whole forever stocks. Like stocks, I don't have to worry about doing a dividend cuts. Dealing with stocks and companies that do dividend hikes every year. It's a bank. 1021, 980. I'm gonna do a buy order. Just buy shit, 980. No dollar coverage down. Do 981. Now I pick a share up. Matter of fact, $20. If I sit there buying $3 here and $3 there, I want to get it at its lowest. Actually, that's not an expensive stock. 1082, 1052. You see, trying to target buy and hold forever companies. BGS 841, 720, $2. It's another company I'm probably gonna shake, trying to get out of that food stuff. Once I get up in that, I'ma sell that too. Try to stick to just REITs and banks. At least one thing about REITs, the value might drop, but if you just reinvest the dividends, you'll be all right. This ain't at a spot I like it at, but I'd take it $2 worth. SCHD, can't go wrong with that. Butterfield Bank. $22.93. Yeah, I just do a buy limit $22.93 for one share. 22.93 if it hits it. So I ain't got to worry about dollar cost averaging. I can, but I'd rather get that one share at the lowest price. Down the bottom, I'm up. Postal. 1323. 1298. PE ratio high too. I just buy a share at $12.98. Like I see, I get a whole share at the lowest price. I say cheap stocks, you know, you can just do a buy order. But them expensive ones, them $100 companies, the $50 and better. You know, unless it's something like Zim. Get my butt whooped in that too. RBSB, I ain't worried about that. So they 52 week low at 4 something. I'm letting my dividends take care of that. I get $16.14 quarterly in dividends. I catch around the 52 week low mark. Excuse me. Starbucks, Golden Oceans. Ooh, 712. No lie, 712 ain't a bad buy for this right now. Golden Ocean, that's not bad at 712. I'm gonna get 10 shares. If it go down, I'm gonna buy another 10. This one here, I'm gonna swing trade it. I like to buy that around the $7 range, but like I said, it's not bad. Golden Oceans. ING, I should be up in that. Just buying a whole forever stock, just keeping that for the dividends. Big Lots, I know I'm getting whooped in that. I want to get that around the $4 mark. Yep, got to buy a limit at $4. I got to buy that at the low. Can't dollar cost average in that one. Hopefully, they start paying back dividends. F. Kill Reed, that's up for the day, ain't worrying about that. SLVO 7129. We'll catch that around the $65 mark, 75 and under. Flake is another bank. First Long Island. 879, that's just hanging around, ain't worrying about that. VIA, ain't worrying about that right now. IAT Banks, one I want to check out. 3178. Now let that come down some more. TSLY. 1074, 1107. It ain't where I want it, but I give him $2 worth. Clip. Do 16. Ooh, Lord, this one fell. 16:27. Buy a shell, add a shell on the clip. Alright, everything else I'm green in Disney. That should be up in that. Oh, I got a Batwood. I must have got a Batwood in this. I got four shells. There we go, 1956. Alright, y'all, and that's it. That's all to it I'm doing today. Subscribe to my channel, hit the like button, watch my recent videos, and I will talk to you later. GGYM, go get your money.